Yes, baby. Let's go. Earl, it's Vega. You tuned in early, baby. I think I'm getting something from you tonight. I must be getting something from you, baby. Yeah, man. What's up to everybody, man? You know what I mean? Another special edition of the Al York Sports Show. We're going to grind today. There's a lot of things to grind about. Hopefully the callers stepped up like they've been telling me they was going to step up. If they don't, I'ma does what I do anyway, man. But salute to Ernesto, Big Ray, all of y'all, man. Vega, I love y'all niggas for giving me the opportunity to shine for y'all, man. Like I said, let me do the work, man. Sit back like a boss and let me work, man. Let me do all the work, man. And with that, before I start the show, I got to give out, you know what I mean, the coronavirus love. Continue to stick to the instructions as given. You know, use your mentality, man. You know, common sense, man. Keep the mask on, constantly sanitize, etc. Just keep doing what y'all doing. Let's limit this. Let's try to defeat this corona shit. I don't know how we going to do it, but let's try. In other news, I got to support my dude, Al York dude, for like 3-4 years. Always shows my show love. Always shows me love when he sees me. He's real sick right now, my man Douglas Bender. I want you to know, daughter, prayers are in for you. God bless you. And like I tell you, man, when I say you a friend, man, I really mean that, man. God bless you, man. And let's jump right into the shout-outs, man. Shout-out to the East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, Las Vegas, New York City, LES to the death. Y'all already know, Triple H Entertainment, Syndicate Radio TV, One Voice, D Beaming. My co-host is, of course, Noah Parker, a.k.a. The Secret Weapon, Juice, a.k.a. The Dog Catcher, and Justin Yu, a.k.a. The Specialist. And Credit Fix, never too late to get your credit. IG me, inbox me, email me at al.newyork@yahoo.com. Let's get this show started, man. Steve Levine, I see you, and you already know what time it is, my brother. And let's get the show started. Let's go to UFC. There's news that Dana White is stepping his game up, the president of MMA or UFC, whatever he the president of. I mean, y'all can configure that. The guy's real smart, man. What he's saying right now, he's got multiple fights set up for May 9th, and it's at a TBD location, which I'm pretty sure he bought that island, and if he didn't buy that island, he's going to have these fights where they're going to produce. They're going to have them. And what I like about him, he's doing whatever it takes to maintain his business and to continue to work, continue to spend money. And you got to have respect for this dude, man. Corona or no corona, Dana White will continue this MMA shit and salute the Dana White. You can only salute him, man. You can't hate on him. And the NFL draft, we're going to start the draft in about April 23rd, if I'm correct, about 3 days from today. I really don't like going through all the draft no more because all you got to do is get one or two wrong and your whole draft is shot. Kind of like a NCAA tournament chart, you know what I mean? So I like to go with what I would say, like the kind of the guarantees, which there's really no guarantee, especially when teams can trade up nowadays and they're utilizing that option. But of course, you know, Joe Burrow, Bengals, we kind of know that. The interesting thing that I really want to see is what the Redskins are going to do. Are the Redskins are going to say, Haskins, here's the ball. You're going to run this team. And then they're going to go after, you know, Chase Young, the best player on the draft. Or they're just going to say, you know what, we don't want to see Haskins out there, you know, on some Jameis Winston shit. And then go get a quarterback. Because at number two, you can get a quality service quarterback that's better than Haskins right now. But then you step back because now you go two quarterbacks. And you got a lot of positions to fill in Redskins world. And you know what I mean? And three, the Lions are tough. Lions, they could get the best cornerback in Jeff Okudah. But I think they might go with Tua Tags. I think Tua make a nice fit with the Lions. I don't know. He's tough. I think he's a gamble because, like you said, coming off injury, you can't really trust nothing. You have to see what's going on because it takes one hit. And then that injury could reoccur. So you the Lions, you want to be smart. You want to be as smart, especially the Lions. You know, you like the third worst record in football. You don't want to take a gamble on nobody. You want to pick a solid pick. So they got a big decision to make there. And also the Miami Dolphins. But the Dolphins are either going to go Tua or Justin Herbert. And the more I'm hearing, I think they're going to go with the kid from Oregon. Justin Herbert. I think he's the most safest pick for Miami to move on forward. And then last but not least, the Giants, they need offensive linemen. They're thinking of getting Tristan Wirfs, outside tackle. But the more I hear this guy, Isaiah Simmons' name, you kind of got to get the better player. If I'm the Giants, I know you need a lineman. You can always get a lineman eventually. I know we always say that, and it kind of never happens. But you got to get this Isaiah Simmons cat. This kid is all over the field. I mean, you got to get this cat if you're the New York Football Giants. And that is the draft. I'm all, like I said, I'm only going five. Phones are open, 917-723-8264. I got two huge topics I'm going to hit up today, but everything else, I'm just going to hit you guys with updates. More updates. NBA players receive a 25% less in their paychecks. Starting May 15th, until then, paychecks are issued out. So anything before May 15th, the NBA guys are going to get their full checks. After May 15th, all of them are getting a 25% pay cut due to the coronavirus pandemic. You dig what I'm saying? So it is what it is, man. Everybody's suffering from this. So if a couple players get 25% off their check, then welcome to the party, because everybody's suffering. And in MLB, MLB raises nearly $1 million for meals for the kids during the pandemic. Also, salute to the major leagues. I figured they could have raised $5 million if they wanted. But, you know, $1 million is something. It beats nothing. Salute to the individuals that participated in this fundraiser to feed the kids that are all in hunger. You know what I'm saying? And in boxing news, Terrence Bud Crawford wants a big fight. Everybody knows that, just like Spence wants a big fight. But Terrence Crawford said he is not selling his soul for a big fight. So basically, the fight has to be the right fight for the right amount of money. And he ain't going to sell his soul, he said. So respect to Terrence Crawford, who just feels like, you know what, he wants the correct fight for him at this point of his career. He's undefeated, and he ain't going to sell himself short. Salute to Terrence Bud Crawford, who won't take a lot of money for a fight he doesn't want. And I respect that. I respect that. And another news, let's keep it pushing, man. Phone lines are open, y'all. Phone lines are open, 917-723-8264. Phil, welcome to call. Anybody's welcome to call. Just keep it sports-oriented as much as you can. If you got something about the virus, I could do that for a couple minutes, but let's keep it as much sports as we could. Okay, another news in the NFL. Jacksonville Jaguars are looking to trade Leonard Fournette, who ran for a career-high 1,152 yards and also had 76 receptions out of a running back. So he only scored 3 touchdowns for the year, but he totaled up for 1,674 total yards from scrimmage. So Fournette would definitely be a huge pickup for any team. Guy out of LSU, the guy's a beast. He probably needs a fresh start. Too much happening in Jacksonville with the Nick Foles debacle. Then you got Mustache starting a rookie. You don't know what you're going to get out of him. I mean, the guy's got an arm. We know that. But what that means if he's going to be your full-time quarterback. So Fournette looking to get out of there, man. And running back Matt Breida of the San Francisco 49ers was signed to a 1-year, 3.2 contract to stay with the 49ers. Kareem Hunt is planning to do the same with Cleveland Browns. He's still waiting on his deal, but he might get something like a 1-2-year deal to stay with the Cleveland Browns. Kareem Hunt, after that incident, man, your career is going down, man. You would have had a championship right now with the Chiefs. You know, you would have been balling. You'd have probably got the contract you deserve. And this is what happened when you kicked the shorty that day in the hotel, man. That little, and I understand problems happen. Listen, none of us is perfect, man. I totally understand shit happens. But you cannot let shit like that happen when you're in that stage. You're on a big stage right now. You can't let that happen, man. Parky, what's up, baby? Salute to you and your family, baby. And Taysom Hill was offered $4.6 million to stay with the New Orleans Saints, which I think he will. It's a perfect fit. Sean Payton runs an offense for him that, you know, that's great. You know, he runs, when Taysom Hill's in that lineup, that offense works to all his strengths. And that's the beauty about Taysom Hill and the Saints, that, you know, Sean Payton's willing to do that. Now, he ain't willing to make him a full-time quarterback, because I don't think he's a full-time quarterback type of dude. But I love the fact that he could come in on third down and one, third down and two, maybe take over a series. If Breeze feels a little tired, he can take over. Taysom Hill is one of the most important guys that do not start in the NFL. And 4.6, you know, he hasn't signed yet. He's looking for a new deal. If I'm the Saints, I sign him maybe 3 years at 15 M's. You can't go wrong with this kid, man. This kid is tough. He broke his leg two times. And he's out there running wild in the NFL like he ain't never broke his leg. It's like usually when you break a bone on your body, you kind of favor that side. It's on your mind. You know what? I broke my shit. But it ain't on his mind. The kid's running out there wild, having fun, strong, constantly works out. Salute to Taysom Hill or the New Orleans Saints. Give him that contract because the contract is well deserved. Guys, call in 917-723-8264. Let's get it popping, man. Let's get these conversations going. I'm heated. I want to talk about that last stand that came out yesterday. That's going to be one of my last topics. But if you guys got anything before that, let's do it, man. And also another news, the New York Jets, Jamal Adams, is looking for a new contract. Will not attend the virtual program. So he's already starting in the wrong foot with the New York Football Jets. They're not seeing eye to eye, and this guy was their only All-Pro. He's actually one of the, definitely their best player defensively. And, you know, he got 2 years left in his contract, and he doesn't want to fulfill it because he's kind of like playing over his contract, which I understand because whenever they give you a big contract and you don't produce to it, it's easy for, you know, the GMs or whatever to release you. I noticed that. But when you're playing over your contract, they beat you on the head on some, yo, play out your contract. You fulfilled it. You know, that's not right. It's funny how that works. Scottie Pippen of the Chicago Bulls had the worst contract ever. But you know what? He signed it. Nobody put a gun to his head when he signed that 7-year, $18 million contract. And by year two, you know, with all the, you know, the contract, you know what I mean? The monies was being raised. Everything was going up. Investments and all that, sponsorship, he was underplaying for his contract. He had like the worst contract for a guy of his skill set. And right now, that's what Adams is trying to avoid. He already made the All-Pro. He wants to get paid, but he got 2 years left. So the Jets are going to have a sticky situation starting the season, fixing up Jamal Adams. If I'm the Jets, I try to trade him and try to get like at least, you know, a number one, a deep number one, maybe an early number two. But he is unhappy. You do not want an unhappy camper on your team. Okay, guys, let me see. Let's get the phone calls going, man. Give me a minute. I think I just missed a call. My bad. Give me a minute, guys. Yeah, call us up. If you just try to call again. 917-723-8264. Phone lines are open. My phone lines are open. And remember, people, what happened with the Houston Astros last year? They got a bunch of suspensions. GM fired. Manager fired. But if this season doesn't take place, whatever suspensions they had or whatever is out the window because this would be considered a year. Give me 1 minute, y'all. We got a phone call here. Yeah, what's up, man? Welcome to the Al York Sports Show. May I ask, who is it, man?
It's Ramon. What's going on, Al?
Ramon, what's up, man? Let me get some bass there, baby.
Yeah, you hear me now?
Yeah. Like I said, Maple Leaf, we arguing. How about that, dog?
All right.
What you got for us, baby? Talk to us.
I just wanted to know how much truth there is to the Giants trying to trade down in the draft this year.
Come again because I got the other line buzzing. I didn't hear the last word.
Yeah, the Giants, I heard they were trying to trade down in the draft for the first time in a long time. I read it in the paper somewhere.
Well, I didn't hear that, so you got to educate me, Ray. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you. I didn't hear that, so that's news to me. If you can educate us, I'd appreciate that.
Because I read in the papers, I'm just trying to figure out which paper I read it in. But my question actually I have for you is, do you think we're going to pick up that kid from Auburn if they're going to have the slot for him? a defensive kid from Auburn. Was that the guy you was talking about earlier?
No, no, Tristan Wirfs. If he's an offensive tackle, yes. My thing is, I don't think they should even think that. I think they should go after that kid Simmons, dog.
A defensive kid, right?
Yeah, go after the kid Simmons, man. He's a linebacker slash safety. Isaiah Simmons. He will be on the board. To me, you got to get the best player available. I know they need offensive linemen for dimes. I understand that. But I think, I always feel like offensive guys, you can always get via trades or down the line in the draft. But it's hard to get the best skill set guys because they usually go quick, right? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm thinking either they're gonna pick an older guy up who's got experience or somebody who just got that straight talent on the offensive line coming out of college. Not too many that happens, too. But I do agree that they need a defensive guy to put some pressure on the ball. You know, to get them in there, you know, get some three and outs.
Right.
Get the offense back on the field.
Right. Now, I haven't kept up with your Giants. My understanding, the last time I had a conversation, I think it was with my boy Venner, he's saying you guys need edge rushers. So you need more of the middle guy, you need the edge. What do you need there? What do you think you need more? You probably need both of them, but what would you want first?
I need somebody to make some noise in the backfield. I need somebody that... You gotta put two people on. Somebody's gonna make some noise out there to give that type of defense that they have a chance to win, you know?
Right.
Yeah, I think that's what you need to go for, an edge rusher, a good one.
Yeah, that's what my boy Venner was saying. Y'all gotta get the edge rusher. And I told him, you guys might luck out if the Redskins become as stupid as they usually do. Because from my understanding, they're not trusting Haskins. And whatever veteran they got over there, they're not trusting them either. So they might pull off a quarterback pickup. And if they do that, I think you can get the kid Young at the fourth overall, because I don't think the Lions are looking to get him. Copy?
Yeah, no, that sounds good to me. I was thinking the same thing. All right. I have too much for you today, bro. I just wanted to see what you're.
Listen, any input you guys, very much appreciated, Ray. Thank you. Let me get this other line, brother.
Yes, sir.
All right, Ray, have a great one. Okay. Yeah, what's up? Welcome to the Al York Sports Show.
Hey, this is Al York. How you doing? This is Noah Parker. How you doing?
Oh, this is my partner that we always disagree.
Yeah, I think I used to do a show with you back in the day.
I know, right? It feels that long. What up, my brother?
Man, you the hype man. I was the brain. That's what it was.
Oh, wow. I was just the hype man.
this is the biggest Michael Jordan supporter out there right now. This is MJ. Probably got some J's on right now.
I ain't got my J's on. Let me show you. You know I keep it real. I got plain socks on. But go ahead, brother.
Okay, I was just wondering, one of your biggest points, what's your biggest point about why Jordan is better than LeBron? What would be your number one reason?
If I had to narrow it down to one, consistency. Continuing to do what he does to be the best. Unlike LeBron James, who I call him Mr. Inconsistent. And don't have me break down why he's inconsistent. I do not want to go through this again. You already heard me a million times.
All I'm saying is he consistently gets to the finals. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. But I just know that when Jordan left his team, they almost made the finals. They were right there. When LeBron leaves...
Almost left the finals. How they almost made the finals?
They were in the Eastern Conference Finals against the Knicks, lost in 7 games with the Bulls. And Jordan retired the first time.
All right, go ahead. I'll give you that, even though... All right, go ahead. You forgot that they got Scottie Pippen, but go ahead.
When Jordan left, they were still that good. When LeBron left the Cavs, he decimated the team last place. When LeBron left the Wayne Wade, they couldn't even get in the playoffs.
All right, hold up. Freeze. You know what you're doing, right? No, you're supporting my argument. So, okay, if LeBron makes everybody better, right? So shouldn't that mean whether he's there or not, they better? Or it's only, or now you're going to, no, you're going to divide it to, oh, he only makes, no, when you make somebody better, let me tell you something. If I made you better as an analyst, that means that whether I'm there or not, you should be better, right or wrong?
No, that's not true.
I'm not buying it, man. I know where you're going with it. One thing I could say is when LeBron leaves franchise, they all fucked. They all fucked. But what's the point? What does that do, though? Does that make him better than Jordan? I don't get it.
No, I'm just saying, I mean, the teams, they got nothing. But when Jordan left the team, they almost made the finals.
But you supported my argument. That means Jordan did a hell of a job when he was there. He taught them well. He taught them well.
But they were still that good, they still made the finals. LeBron left the team, they had no talent. That's how much talent was on the team around him. There's no talent, and he's still that good to carry that team to the finals.
All right, listen, I'm gonna give you that, but what does that prove? Like, I mean, that they better, that the teams are worse, that they really bad without him, correct? That's what you're trying to prove?
I'm just saying, yeah, he took some bad teams to the finals. That 06 team he took, or the 08 to the Spurs, they swept him. Man, you can't tell me one player on that team besides Eric Snow.
Man, all I got to tell you, listen, all I got to tell you, Michael had to go against the bad boys. You guys don't know how good the bad boys. Listen, y'all going to watch that last stand. They're going to talk about the bad boys. Trust me. They already nipped a little bit of it, but they're going to make a big thing out of it. The bad boys, listen, the bad boys were serious. Huh?
The bad boys would get destroyed by the Golden State Warriors. Had no offense. All they do was They only score 85 points a game.
There you go. You thinking offense was championship, defense was championship to me, but
it don't matter
in the
game
because
they call everything.
Well, listen, that's a topic that could go either way, so I really don't want to.
I'm going to give Jordan this. If I'm going to talk about Jordan and LeBron, you're going to compare them. I'm not going to call either of them the GOAT. I'm going to say called G-O-H-T, GOAT. I'm spelling it that way. The greatest of his time. Jordan is the greatest of his time, G-O-H-T. LeBron is the greatest of his time, G-O-H-T. I'm not having the greatest of all time.
Listen, man. Listen. I'm not mad at you being a LeBron fan. Hold on. You got to let me talk. I'm not going to let you talk, and you ain't going to let me talk, dog. I don't care if you my co-host. You going to let me talk, nigga. Or ninja. Let me phrase it. Ninja. I'm not using that word no more. That's a great analogy. I like how you thought about this all night to Showtime to say that they're the greatest of their time. Kind of like that dude Serge yesterday on the comments who brings up all these reasons why Mike ain't the GOAT, but he couldn't give me an individual player. That makes no sense. That's like when I said Floyd Mayweather wasn't the best. I named you three other boxers that I thought were the best. You don't bring a man down and then don't have somebody to step up in his spot. And he made all these points that Bill Russell got more rings. Will Chamberlain was the best offensive stats guy. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is the winningest center. What that means if you ain't got a guy for me? At least you got LeBron. But like I told you, Noah, I'm tired of raping this subject. I was hoping you'd bring a different name up. I'm done with LeBron. I mean, there's not even nothing to talk about no more.
There's nobody close to LeBron or Michael Jordan. It's a huge drop-off of talent.
I disagree. You got a lot of Kobe guys out there. You got a lot of Kobe guys out there that feel like that Kobe was better than LeBron.
Kobe got the worst field goal percentage in history. Nobody worse than him in the history of the game.
Who made more clutch shots when it counted? Answer that question.
He missed more shots than anybody that ever played the game, and he got his assists and rebound per game not even close to even MJ.
Yo, dog, I'm going to tell you right now, LeBron James, you need to start comparing them to Magic and Bird. No more Kobe and Michael. Kobe and Michael are killers. Hold up. Let me talk. I'll let you get your nut. You got to let me get my nut. LeBron, like you said, he makes everybody better. You know what? Put him with Steve Nash. Put him with John Stockton. Don't put him with killers. You cannot put a guy that flocks like LeBron next to killers. Kobe, and Jordan were killers. LeBron, like I said, is more like Magic, Stockton, and Nash. Case over. I don't even want to talk about that. What else you got for us today, Noah Parker?
Where is the Magic on the all-time scoring list?
What else you got for us, Noah?
Where's Magic on the all-time caller? Did he in the final?
Noah, what else you got for us? Let's move on, please.
You're talking about he can't score. He's about to be number one in 3 years.
That's, though, how many years he played already? Almost 20?
You have his 17th year.
So what are you saying? So you saying he's averaging like Jordan?
All I'm saying is
if he... Is he averaging like Jordan? Jordan is 30 points a game. Is LeBron averaging that, what you're telling me?
So you're going to say James Harden better because he averages 30 points a game?
That's 1 year, and Harden ain't got no defense, so Harden's not in this conversation. I don't know why you're putting words in my mouth. Harden is not in this conversation. Harden got the worst defense. Yo, let me tell you something. Mike does it all. Everything. That's not one thing Mike don't do. He can steal the rock, play lockdown D, hit a three, go to the hole, makes his foul shots, comes through in the clutch, averages 30 plus, got 6 rings. What else do you want this mother hubba to do, dog? He does everything. He did everything. LeBron doesn't close. Everybody knows that. That's my knock with LeBron. He got the body of work. I'm going to use your terminology. LeBron got the body of work. No question about that. I love LeBron for that. But LeBron is not a killer. He go in there and rather get the ball up then take over the game, dog. Dog, you weigh 100 pounds more than everybody. One thing I give Shaquille O'Neal props, though he can't shoot, he can't make a foul shot, but when Neal get the rock inside, he's banging the shit out all the time. Shaquille's a monster. I felt LeBron, he ain't Shaquille, but he was so much bigger than everybody else. Now what you gonna tell me? That wasn't his game? That's what you're going to hit me with? No, come on, dog.
Carmelo Anthony got more game winners than Kobe Bryant. That makes him more of a killer?
Come on, dog. Melo got no defense. You cannot put guys. Noah, you can't put guys that don't play both sides. LeBron, I give it to you. He's got tremendous defense and one of my best defensive plays ever. I'm going to keep it gully. You don't give my man no props. I'm going to give your man props. Is when Iguodala tried that crazy shit under the rim and LeBron came out of nowhere and blocked that shit in the chip. That was one of my best defensive plays in a crucial time that I ever seen. But that doesn't mean he fucked with my man MJ. But go ahead.
I was just bringing up Melo because I'm saying when you're talking about just clutching it, you can throw Iverson, you can throw Chauncey Billups, big shot. I mean, there's people that take more shots. He's just more of a shot taker. Kobe don't take that shot. That wasn't who...
Yo, you know what? I'm going to make sure if I ever could get through LeBron James, I'm going to send him a picture, a call with your picture on it and say that you his biggest fan, dog. And I mean this shit. I respect you for that. You know why? Because it shows your loyalty. Remember, you my co-host. So if this is the loyalty that comes with you, oh, I'm in love, dog. I definitely appreciate you. Because if you're going to talk about LeBron like this, then I know you're going to talk about me like this, too. So, you know what? I appreciate where you stand at, bro.
How many game winners LeBron got in his career? Over or under 25?
Nigga, I ain't going to look at that, man.
How many game winners he got over or under 25, what you think, in his career?
Well, I'm going to say over since you're bringing it up.
It's obviously over. He's almost 30.
16 seasons. 16 seasons. Jordan got like 10 in one season. So what you telling me?
No. Jordan got about 35 for his career. LeBron right there with 25. So I'm just saying, I'm just throwing numbers up there.
Listen, you got anything else? Because I got 4 people trying to call. I'm not trying to take you off the phone.
I'm just saying, when LeBron's done with his career, he's going to pass everybody.
Listen, LeBron would be top 5. Look at top 5 in my book. He could be the best. Look at, we all entitled to our own opinions. Look, I'm not going to say you wrong. I'm only going to make my facts and let the people determine what they want to determine. Because to me, if you bring the facts, people are going to listen. But if you're just going to say, if you're just going to like make them great for certain shit and then don't knock them for other shit, people not feeling that. Either keep it 100 or don't keep it at all. And one thing about LeBron James, look at great, great talent, great player. I'm thankful to see him in this era since we were lacking a lot of superstars after Mike and them left. But, He's just not the GOAT to me, and I've seen enough of both of them to know. And let me tell you, listen, and let me make this clear. My favorite player ain't Michael Jordan. My favorite player is Magic Johnson. I hated Michael Jordan. He beat my Knicks every year. So I have all the right to lean on LeBron right now. But I can't, because then I'm not keeping it 100. I'm not telling y'all the raw truth. The raw truth tells me to keep it real. Keeping it real, Jordan's the dude. Ain't no other way around it. Let me tell you something. I'd rather put Kareem, my man Humpty's man, second over LeBron James. And I'm going to leave it like that.
But when LeBron passes Karl Malone, Michael Jordan, and Kareem,
then he'll be the nicest stats guy. Like Will Chamberlain was a nice stat guy. Congratulations. That doesn't make you the GOAT, though. You got anything else? You got anything else, brother?
No, I'm just saying you can't compare him to Magic Johnson, because Magic Johnson wasn't even close.
Well, since you, a lot of people say, yo, but he passes the ball first. I heard Serge say that yesterday. I heard you say it the other day. So if you want to talk about he want to make everybody better, then you know what? Then we're going to keep it real. You saying he's not a killer like Kobe and Jordan. Okay, let's keep it real. Let's put him with Steve Nash and John Stockton and them then.
How can he beat those guys, though, if he's about to pass Kareem in 3 years?
So then you got to make your argument clear, dog. You confusing me. One minute you telling me, yo, he's not a killer, he don't got Jordan's game, and now you telling me why should he be? No, you trying to confuse me. That's not going to happen with me.
You do all of the above, that's why.
No, you're not going to confuse me. I'm old school, nigga. Like, I got my head beating so much in my whole life that I already see it coming before it comes, dog. And I love that. Like I said, look, I love your loyalty. I love your loyalty. But, you know. Huh?
Shout out to
Noah Parker. Yo, shout out to Noah Parker. You my dog, and hopefully we'll get up soon, baby. I love that we disagree, so the people know that what we doing is not premeditated. We don't know what we bringing. All right, brother. Have a good one. All right, guys. Whoever been trying to call, I apologize. Y'all seeing the heated discussion with me and my co-host, Noah Parker. Phones are open, 917-723-8264. This is why I created this open session, because opinions are like assholes. Everybody got one. So let's do it, man. You know what I mean? I'm tired of making it all me. I'm spreading love, man. But y'all got to show love back. If I'm telling y'all, call in, man. Yo, put the knowledge out there. Everybody that I hit up on, you know me, on the inbox, whatever, it's because I trust in your knowledge, man. Okay, welcome to the Al York Sports Show. Talk to me.
What up, champ?
What's going on, baby? Yo, we got 26 minutes. I didn't even know time flew that fast.
Shit.
Can you take 5 or you going to need 10?
I can take 5.
Go ahead, talk to the peoples, my brother.
And it needs, you know what I mean? Get out my cage and bet on some of this shit.
Yo, I already know, dog. I know you. Let me tell you something. Let me make this clear again. The reason why I named my man Juice the dog catcher, because nobody hit them dogs like my man Juice. And we coming. Once they open them doors up, we're going to be in there. And Juice, you just do what you do. Don't step off from what you've been doing, dog. That's all I can tell you.
Oh, yeah. I got to keep it going.
Yeah.
About, and a lot of these casinos, they putting a lot of pressure on the governor.
Right. Talk up, Juice.
Okay. Hold on.
You know what? Make believe you at the book, because at the book, you the loudest motherfucker in there.
Oh, and I'm arguing, and I'm talking shit.
No, you just loud, period. I be hearing you when I be ordering food, dog. Give me that motherfucker right there. Cameron Boy, I see you, baby. Salute. Kevin Coleman, I see you. Yeah, dog.
They're trying to open some things back up. A lot of pressure on the governor. The governor's trying to slow pace it. But you got the mayor against them and a bunch of experts saying if they don't get this thing cracking soon, Vegas gonna lose control. It's just gonna take a big dive.
Right. So let me educate the audience. What he's talking about is the state of Vegas reopening the casinos, etc. And from my understanding, Juice, you're leaning on the Wynn being the first to reopen, correct?
Correct.
Okay, educate the audience and try, like I said, take 5 minutes. I got a lot to catch up on, but go ahead, educate them real fast.
Well, they're thinking about what they're going to basically go have thermal cameras. They're talking about having some thermal cameras where they have the cameras and technology read your temperature as soon as you walk through the door.
Fuck out of here.
If it's north of 100, they're going to send you to another room and actually test you.
Wow. Some James Bond shit?
Yeah, some James Bond shit. They're going to do it like that. And then the Wynn was talking about all the employees going to have gloves and masks, but I believe they're going to hand masks off to the guests as well.
Okay. Now, real fast, right? I don't do table play. My understanding is if you lessen the tables, it kind of defects the game with something about the cards won't be enough. See, I don't know about this because I never play tables. I stick to what I know, which is sports. But I know you used to play tables. You told me, and you told me you used to, you know, used to go in hard. Now, how are they going to do this with this corona thing? They can't have, you know, the tables be, everybody be congested, you know, like a love song being played in the club and everybody on top of each other. So how do you take that away and still continue to run a table game?
Well, the problem is the Wynn records, they're losing about $3 million a day right now.
Right. And profits.
And profits, yes. What they want to do is they're trying to have some kind of money come through to keep stay afloat. But when you lessen the players at a table game, it can be good or bad. Why? Well, if you catch a run, let's say you catch a hot deck, and you're the player, there's more cards that the dealer has to go through, which plays in your favor.
Copy.
Now, if you got a bad deck, you can get slumped up a lot worse because they got to go through that deck. So it plays on both sides of the coin. And then you can add in the card counters. It favors the player more because you can count cards, you can shuffle count, you can do more. The more the players involved, the harder it is to track the shuffle and the card. The less the players, the more it favors the experienced gamblers.
Well, I'm pretty sure my fan base looking in are confused because I'm confused. But I know you try to give it to us as good as you could, and I appreciate you for that. But my thing is, let's go back to the fact of the amount of people. Like, what are they planning to do? My understanding is the machines, they're going to have player, no one, and a player to give that social distancing, that distance for every people don't be on top of each other. How the tables are going to operate? Are they going to go 3 heads on a table, 4 heads on the table? Did you hear anything about the tables, the amount of people being per table?
They're talking, again, one empty chair in between players.
Okay. That's not 6 feet, though.
If you got a six-player game, you now got a three-player game.
Yeah, but that's 3 feet.
Exactly. You got 3 feet, and then the dealer wears the gloves and mask, and then they're talking about the player will wear a mask as well. And then they'll have people walking the floor trying to notice any symptoms that's been matched up by experts in regards to coronavirus. And if they feel that you have symptoms, then they can test you.
So you saying if I'm in there and I cough like I just did now, like I'm a candidate?
You can be.
Now that's bullshit.
You can be. But not like one cough, but I mean, you know what I mean, like coughing or wheezing or anything, any symptom they're talking about that's noticeable, they're saying that they can ask to test you. And the reason why, again, and all the employees and all that, they got furloughed all the employees. All of South Point is pretty much furloughed. All of Caesar's Palace. So a lot of employees going to lose their shit, basically. But they just trying to weather the storm to have that income come back into the city.
Okay.
There's a lot of pressure on the governor right now.
Okay, I got 2 questions for you, then we're going to exit out. Mm-hmm. Real quick, is this going to work? Question number one, in your professional opinion.
In regards to regards to what?
The plan they got. The plan that they coming up with.
Work as far as some income coming in, or just
no work period. Like, is it gonna, you know, it's gonna contain the coronavirus and all that?
Shit, no. In my opinion.
Right, shit, right. No. Okay, in you answer opinion. That. Now we're gonna jump subjects because we got time. We you know, we've been limited on time.
Mm-hmm.
Give me something. Why you think whoever's the GOAT in your book and why? Make that as quick as you can. The GOAT of the NBA.
The GOAT of the NBA?
Yes. Whatever's on your mind. I don't care if you say Shaquille O'Neal. Just whatever's on your mind.
Well, I'm going to go with Jordan.
Jordan? Why would you go with Jordan? I mean, you know, I got a guy that just called that says LeBron's better than him. Why would you go with Jordan? I mean, tell me why.
The one reason why I'm going to say it, he wins when it counts. He's won when it counts. And I'm talking championships.
Yeah, but to them, that don't mean shit. They saying, what does that mean?
Well, shit, I mean, what are we playing for then?
That's what I'm trying to say. We play to win the game. Right or wrong?
That's it.
We play to win the games.
You watched the documentary yesterday. You know what it was about.
I'm sure. Yo, they don't want to know. They don't want to know. It's, shit could be right in front of their face, dog. They don't want to know. And with that, brother, listen, anything else before we move forward, brother, I appreciate the knowledge.
Do you, man.
Listen, appreciate the knowledge. I love the fact that you went outside the box. We need to educate our peoples, especially in Las Vegas, because that's where I'm residing at. So I appreciate, and anything you continue to get, I would love that you spaz it out on our show, brother. Thank you, and I appreciate you, dog.
No problem.
All right, have a great day, my brother. Okay, brother. All right, guys. 917-723-8264. The calling numbers. I know we had about four other people trying to call. You can call back, guys. We got about 17 minutes. You can call back. I can give y'all 5 minutes apiece, man. Call back. But like I was saying, the Houston Astros might get lucky. Okay, we got a call. Yeah, what's up? Welcome to the Al York Sports Show, man. I ask, who is it? Hello. Well, you got to try again. I can't hear you. Yeah, so the Astros, if there's no baseball, they can defeat whatever one-year suspensions that happen, which I think is totally bogus. I mean, nobody expected this corona thing to happen, but that's why from the beginning, when they gave that 1 year, a lot of us was upset. Like, why is it so light? Why is it so light? They got caught cheating. They got people snitching on their cheating. Why is it so light? And now look it. They got MLB got smacked right in their face. Try to give a light suspension, and now they might not even get a suspension at all. Because if there's no season, then what suspension they really had when you think about it? Because this is going to count as part of their suspension. Okay, another news. Let me get back. You know what? Let me bring this topic up. We got about 15 rough minutes. Phone lines are open, 917-723-8264. Please continue to try to call in, gentlemen and ladies. If you didn't get through, I apologize. Y'all seen I was busy on the phones. Okay, the NBA future. I got two players I'm going to mention now. And I think this is definitely part of the future, these two individuals. One being, of course, Zion Williamson, who played only 19 games this year, averaged 23.6, 6.8 rebounds, 2.2 assists, foul shots for 64.5%. Zion Williamson, if I had to bring up one player that he really reminds me of, there's a couple players, but if I had to narrow it down to one, would be a young Sir Charles Barkley. And like I said, some of y'all could disagree. It's all right. Hold up. Let's see if this person can hear. Hello, Al York Sports Show. May I ask, who is it?
This is Buck Flair, Chuck Thomas.
Chuck Thomas, what's up, baby? What you got for us, man? I'm surprised you utilized that phone. I thought you had something with the phone, dog. But what's up? What you got for us, man?
Well, I love that hat you got on.
Oh, thank you, brother. But let me make it clear, I'm not a Bulls fan.
I know you're not.
Yeah, I got a bunch of, listen, I wear every jersey, but I'm first to tell you, I love my bum-ass Knicks, my bitch-ass Cowboys, and my real New York Yankees. But go ahead, brother. What you got for us?
Well, if you watch the documentary, which I really, really enjoyed last night, you can tell the GOAT was in action.
No doubt. No doubt.
The guy that I saw growing up in the Carolinas, since I'm from the Carolinas, since he was a rookie in North Carolina, and it's amazing how people don't realize in these younger generations. I made a post the other day about if you were born in 1987 and up, you have no clue what you missed in the NBA.
Facts. You have no clue what you missed. YouTube can only show you but so much, but it's not the same. But go ahead, Chuck.
But anyway, I know you're a Knicks fan. I know you missed out.
I've been dying, man. I've been dying as a Knicks fan, but go ahead, man.
I know you missed out on Patrick Ewing not getting that ring. I feel you with that one because if anybody deserved a ring, I discussed this topic the other day. He sure did deserve a ring in New York.
I mean, we had everything. You know, we had everything. We had Pat Riley. You know, we had everything John decked Starks. Up. Yeah, two winners. Starks was like somebody a lot of us didn't expect to be as good, even though he choked in a chip. But I think Starks was definitely one of those overachiever players. You know, nobody seen John Starks coming. It wasn't like he made noise in college, you know. But he came up real small when we really needed him. And that's what I think really hurted us. Because we had two games at Houston. We just had to win one to win a championship. And like you said, if you wasn't born at a certain year, when the Knicks won, I think, if I'm correct, was 71, our last championship. If I'm correct, I didn't get to see that, man. And I finally had a chance to see it. Like
71 or 73, I can't remember which year. It
might have been 71. Right. Now, my Cowboys.
I know Phil Jackson was on that team. That's what a lot of people don't realize.
Right.
That Bulls documentary, because people don't realize that Jerry Krause actually was trying to recruit Phil Jackson with the Washington Bullets when he was a scout.
Copy.
So Jerry Krause actually has a long connection with Phil Jackson.
No, he do. And a lot of people do not give Krause credit for that. You know, Krause was like, you know, he's one of them short guys with a chip on his shoulder. We all know that. But one thing we have to admit, that he made pickups when he had to. He pulled the string on that big Charles Oakley trade for Mr. Bill Cartwright, that a lot of people in Chicago were really upset with him. But like Michael said, that trade gave him a championship. That's what they needed, was a big man. And yep. Bill provided that for the Chicago Bulls. And I love Bill Cartwright because he used to play with the Knicks. I love Mr. Bill. Yep. But, you know, that was the best thing that happened in his career was to go to Chicago and pick up that championship. But go ahead, bro.
But another thing that I like to point out was Krause. These younger generations have no clue how he was hated so much on the Bulls organization and from the fans, pretty much. They really did hate that guy, and it's funny because the biggest issue I think came out was because they were ready to put this out in 2018, and they didn't do it.
Right.
And I think a lot of that had to do with because Krause died in 2017, and I didn't think they wanted to mess with the man's family and all that kind of good stuff, give him time to respect his family and give his wishes or whatever. So that's why you're seeing this come out now, and it just amazes me how people can still say LeBron is better than Michael Jordan. It blows my mind.
My man,
once they watch this documentary, I hope that helps them change their mind because there's really no discussion when it comes to that.
Chuck Thomas, I probably got at least 3 to 4 videos, and they still coming at me. I feel like a broken record already. I understand their loyalty to LeBron. Listen, the thing is, we're not saying LeBron's a bad player. I got him top 5. People mad at me because of that. Oh, how you got him top 5? He should be the best or second. I don't see him like that, dog. Because, you know, I just don't see him like that. I mean, I'm not going to lie to y'all. Like, I'm almost got Kobe in front of him. And I'm being realistic. I almost got Kobe. I got him at a tie right now.
Gonna be mad at me because I got Larry Bird still over him.
No, I'm not mad at you because Bird was nice. But the thing with Bird, though, what I love about Bird, for a guy that lacked many abilities like jump, speed, he did everything else that much better. The guy could pass his ass off. That was very underrated about Larry Bird. Everybody talks about this three-point shot, the jump shot. Larry Bird was one of your best no-look passes of the game. Am I lying or not, Chuck?
You're right. And the only person that could pass probably better than him would be Magic
Johnson. Exactly.
I think he probably
picked up some of that skill set from Magic. Just like Magic was a horrible jump shooter early in his career, but in the latter of his career, he got a lot better, right or wrong? So he probably got that from Bird.
The thing about it is, on a previous show, you just had me feeling some love when you were talking about James Worthy, Jamal Wilkes, Kirk Rambis,
yep.
Michael Cooper, all the guys. You brought up all the names that we grew up with in the 80s, and the guys just do not know what kind of basketball we had in the 80s, and they missed out on it. They can watch YouTube. And they missed out on that guy.
You know what they call us? They say old school fighting basketball. That's what all the young guys say. And if they only knew, and now don't get me wrong, Golden State Warriors, let me make this clear. They changed the game, you know, like they set a new they set their own trend with everybody being able to pull up from three and all of that stuff. Even though we kind of seen that with the Phoenix Suns. But the problem was the Suns didn't win no championships. Golden State did it in a way where they also played some defense. This is why they won championship, because the defense aspect of that style of play. If you see the Houston Rockets, they also got that style of play, but they got no chips because they got no defense. So the only reason why Golden State was able to win three chips is because the element of playing defense, but they don't understand that. But that's not to say they had one of the best defensive. No, they played enough defense with that firepower offense. But to me personally, defense wins championships. Pitching wins championships. And I'm just a true believer of that. I've been seeing it every year. Once in a while, you get the better offensive team to win. But at the long run, if you really break it down, defenses win championships, bro. And they just run and gun. Am I lying or not?
You're not lying, but
run and gun, just like TMC.
I got one thing to bring up with you, because I know you're a Cowboys fan, and I just recently had my mock show, and I'm just gonna give you some heads up.
Talk to me.
You just said defense wins championship, and I'm just gonna give you my quick analysis of the Cowboys real quick, and I'm gonna give you my picks for the Cowboys. I think they take the defensive end out of LSU with the first pick.
Mm.
And then I'm going with a safety out of California, Ashton Davis. And then
okay.
I'm going with a tight end, Thaddeus Moss, out of LSU, to come with the Cowboys.
Yeah, I like Moss. That's Randy's son, correct?
Yep. I think the Cowboys are going to take him just because of the name and the notoriety. They got their tight end in the third round, and then the final round they're going to get their cornerback. And there you go. Your three out of your first four picks better be defense if you want to try to win this season.
Okay, let me ask you something. If love is available at that 17th spot, is it 17th, correct?
Yes, sir.
If love is available, do you take love?
No, I do not.
Okay.
I got love actually going to the Jacksonville Jaguars unless the Patriots decide to move up in the draft to take Jordan Love.
Okay.
And then my upset sleeper of the draft, since I'm from here in Indianapolis, Indiana, is that Jalen Hurts will be drafted by the Indianapolis Colts. See, I can't get Baltimore out of my mouth, so that's where they should have stayed. But Indianapolis Colts will take Jalen Hurts. That's my upset pick in the draft.
But you sure they need Hurts, because they still got Brissett over there to back up Phillip Rivers, who'll probably play a year, max 2 years. Would you really want to congest that quarterback spot now? I mean, Brissett knows the offense.
Here's the key. I think the key is where he's going to fall to. I think they're going to get him in the third round, which is not going to be a big money issue, because the same thing the Seahawks did with Russell Wilson. That's what they did with Russell Wilson. They got him as a fourth rounder, and they were able to hold their salary cap in place. So,
right.
I mean, I'm not big on Hurts, but I just know with the way the game is being played right now with the Lamar Jacksons and the Allen kid out of Buffalo, that's just the way Mahomes, even though he's not a runner, he still can get out of the pocket and make those plays. But I'm really excited to see how this Tua thing is going to really make the draft interesting, because he's really the key to the whole puzzle on what happens with that third pick in Detroit if they're going to trade down and give that to the Chargers so they can get him. Or there be another team that moves up?
Right, but like I'm going to bring up a statement, and actually heard this from Rex Ryan. I'm not going to take credit for it. Big old Rex that used to coach the New York Football Jets. And one thing about Rex, he said, and I was feeling him. He said, how can you risk a top, like, first-round draft pick on a guy that came off such an injury that you got no clue what he is at the moment, because nobody can detect exactly where he's at. You got to take their word in for it. Not only that, you don't know if he's one hard hit away from being hurt again with that same injury. So why would a franchise invest in such a situation that it can backfire on them? Now, we're not saying Tua ain't tough. That kid is as tough as they come. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about his prior injury, which was that hip injury. So you being the Lions in Miami, do you take the risk on picking up Tua Tagovailoa?
I've got Miami going. I think they're going to stick with Justin Herbert.
Yes. Yes, that makes the most sense.
Stuck with that one. Here's something for you, though, to rely on, because California is such a messed up state. They didn't announce it, but not have any games in L.A. If they draft Tua, do you think the state of Alabama will allow them, Chargers, to come down there to Alabama and play their games during this NFL season?
I like that. But listen, real quick. Salute to my boy Douglas Bender. Great news. He's out the hospital and he's going to be all right. God bless you, my brother. I have to find a minute to call that out there. Salute to you, and I'm proud of you, my brother. Okay, Chuck, you got anything else before we hang it up, brother?
No, I appreciate the time, and I'm pretty sure I'll be back on the show this
week. Oh, you got to get. No, pretty sure. You got to get on the show. You just dropped some knowledge on us, which was heavily appreciated. And thank you, Chuck Tyler. And go Bucks, man. Go Bucks.
Here you go, Brady.
Okay, brother.
All right, brother.
Okay, have a good one, man. Okay, that was Chuck Thomas. Guys, man, I can't believe an hour's over, man. This is how fun it is. I apologize to the individuals that couldn't get through. Like I said, you got to find your slot. If you're looking at the show, the first 15 minutes, y'all could have got in. Y'all got to look at it and then dial so you can see where I'm at. Because if y'all just outside and y'all just dialing, y'all not going to know when to call or when to find a spot. So, like I said, I appreciate that you try to call. I wanted to speak to Ernest. I wanted to speak to Steve. I wanted to speak to Ray. Hopefully, we could push these topics to Thursday. But I really wanted to get these topics off. But we got 2 minutes left. You know what? I can't even get into the next subject. I wanted to get in to the next great NBA stars, which is Zion Williamson. I gave you his numbers. And John Morant, who played 59 games, averaged 17.6, 3.5 rebounds, 6.9 assists, shot 77% from the foul line. These are the two new NBA futures, which my bum Knicks couldn't get either or. I thought we was going to get at least either or. But that's how sad my franchise is. I mean, like they say, God ain't going to give you everything your way. I got the Cowboys. I got the Yankees. That's enough to keep my head above water. But my Knicks is keeping me where they're trying to bring me underwater. And it's sad because every year we go in thinking, like the New York Mets, that we have an opportunity. But I'm at a point right now where I'm just don't even give a fuck no more. I mean, I'm going to stay a Knicks fan, but it is what it is, man. We the worst franchise, and as long as we got, you know what I mean, the dude on top run of us, man, I can't stand that dude. I don't even want to give him no clout right now. That's why I don't even want to say his name. But, yo, God bless everybody. Thank you for another edition. Thank you for tuning in to Open Sessions. And we're going to go back on Thursday. Salute to Douglas Bender for his recovery. Great luck. I wish you continue the process. Salute for everybody for calling in, giving your opinions. Salute to everybody who's on Team Jordan. And I love you guys. I thank you guys. And with that, keep your heads up. Ernest Vega, I wanted to hear from you, but I'll get you next time. One love, y'all. Al York Sports, bringing it right to y'all with a Wu-Tang classic, baby. Hold your heads, baby. 100, man.